This is a Disneyland original little long-playing record, and I am your story reader. I am going to begin now to read the story of Babes in Toyland. You can read along with me in your book. You will know it is time to turn the page when Tinkerbell rings her little bells like this. Let's begin now.
Hello, I'm Little Boy Blue. You know, the one who lost his horn and let the sheep in the meadow and the cows in the corn. I'm going to tell you the story of Babes in Toyland. I know all about what happened because I was there. Everything started the day Tom Tom, the piper's son, and Mary Mary Quite Contrary decided that they would get married. They told everyone in Mother Goose Village about their plans. There was a big celebration. Everyone was happy, except Barnaby, a mean, crooked man who lived in a crooked house. Barnaby wanted to marry Mary himself. He told his two helpers, Gonzargo and Rodrigo, that he wanted them to kidnap Tom and throw him into the sea. After the party, Tom took Mary home. Gonzargo and Rodrigo hid just outside the garden of her house. As soon as Mary said goodnight to Tom and went inside, they kidnapped him. But they didn't throw him in the sea. They sold him to a band of gypsies instead. The day of the wedding, they came to Mary and told her Tom had drowned. Mary believed Rodrigo and Gonzargo and wept bitterly. Barnaby tried to get her to marry him. He even promised her a castle in Spain. Then little Bo Peep lost all of Mary's sheep. Now Mary had no way of earning money to buy food or clothes. She sat for hours trying to think of a way to make ends meet. At last she decided she would have to accept Barnaby's offer. Barnaby was so happy that he gave a party and invited a band of gypsies to entertain. One of the gypsies was Tom, dressed as a fortune teller. You should have seen Barnaby's face when he discovered Tom was still alive. While Mary and Tom were having a happy reunion, we kids decided to go looking for Bo Peep sheep. We got lost in the forest of no return. Tom and Mary found us among the big, scraggly trees that walked and talked. The trees kept nudging us toward Toyland. When we reached Toyland, the first person we saw was the nice old toy maker. He was standing beside a strange-looking machine his helper Grumio had invented. The machine was supposed to make toys. First it began to stutter and pop. Then, with a great boom, it blew up. The toy maker was very unhappy. Without the machine, he did not think he could have the toys ready for Christmas. Grumio made a new invention, the poof gun. It turned real things into toy things. The toy maker was overjoyed until Tom asked him where he was going to get the big things to make into little toys. The toy maker was so annoyed, he threw the poof gun out of the window. Barnaby, Gonzargo, and Rodrigo had followed us to Toyland. When the toy maker threw the poof gun away, Barnaby got it. While everybody was asleep that night, he slipped into the toy maker's house and poofed him. The toy maker shrank to toy size. He was still alive, but he was only 6 inches tall. Gonzargo and Rodrigo didn't like this and told Barnaby they were quitting. With two quick poofs, Barnaby reduced them to toy size and put them in a birdcage. Then he poofed Tom, too. Now, said Barnaby to Mary, you and I are going to be married. As mayor of Toyland, the tiny toy maker was to perform the ceremony. When Barnaby wasn't looking, Tom slipped into the workshop and started up all the toys. Before the toy maker had time to perform the wedding ceremony, Tom, leading the toys, burst into the room and yelled, "Stop!" The toys fired every weapon they had at Barnaby, cannons and guns loaded with corks and marbles. But Tom and the toys were too small to hurt him. Barnaby grabbed the poof gun. At the same time, Mary fired the toy cannon at him. It hit the poof gun, and Barnaby was reduced to toy size. Now that the fight was even, Tom was able to drive Barnaby into a toy box and capture him. At this point, Grumio arrived with a new gadget, a poof-poof gun. With one shot, he restored the toy maker, Tom, Gonzargo, and Rodrigo to full size, but not Barnaby. Tom put him in the birdcage to be guarded for life by Sylvester the goose. Then Tom and Mary got married, and everyone lived happily ever after.
Gonna shoot him in the head!
Oink, 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 ding, 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 ding.